Adobe Commerce Optimizer is a pathway to modernizing your website. And interestingly enough, it's not just for Adobe Commerce.
Ooh, this is nice!
As an e-commerce practitioner specializing in multiple platforms, I bring you my independent view to understanding this really interesting tool. In this video, we will dissect Adobe Commerce Optimizer's capabilities, and I'm going to give you the jargon-free inside scoop on how this impacts you. We're going to wrap it up with the migration path. Are you ready? Let's jump in. Websites are typically one combo package of visitor experience, admin area, and business logic, all wrapped up in one. This does work, but there are some disadvantages. It can be slow, both in terms of site speed and the ability to add new features. Upgrades are often expensive for open source versions of these systems. However, a new paradigm comes into focus when we realize that most e-commerce platforms have an extensive API, which is code word for a programmatic mechanism for communication. So kind of like two toddlers fighting, what if we separated the visitor experience from the business logic? Suddenly, we can now build a feature on the customer-facing side and not even touch the business side, or vice versa. The result is more stability and less risk. And that's where Optimizer steps in. Except it's not just a customer-browsable website. It is a suite of tools that takes data from another e-commerce platform like Adobe Commerce or Magento 2, Shopify, BigCommerce, or Salesforce Commerce Cloud, improves it, and then sends it back to the customer browsable website. Then, and this is an incredibly key point, the cart and the checkout are on the original platform. In other words, keep your e-commerce system, but kick the visitor experience into overdrive. Side benefit is the effort to build this becomes far less than a complete rebuild. So, what's the nuts and bolts of how this optimizer thing actually works? First, there's the visitor experience, or the front end. It's called Storefront. All this lingo is really crazy. So Storefront, the customer experience, loads data from Adobe's catalog system. Well, where does this get its data from? Adobe's catalog system has already pulled product data from your e-commerce platform. Again, Shopify, BigCommerce, Magento, Salesforce Commerce Cloud, and it has then beefed it up. And actually, if you want more information about Storefront, I have a video right here or in the description below that explains everything you need to know about Storefront. And Adobe is also bringing their Experience Manager digital asset management tools, which is going to really provide next level support for hosting and even modifying images. Then pieces of this are also tied into Adobe's AI system to really power up those merchandising capabilities. And don't forget that this also uses yet another named solution, Edge Delivery Services. And this is a new content management system from Adobe that makes it really cool and easy to publish beautiful content. And I have a video for that right up here as well.
This is getting out of hand.
So why does this matter to me? I mean, how is this going to help me? Put very simply, if you are thrilled with your e-commerce experience, you feel like you're nailing your revenue goals, you're able to push landing pages out there with relative ease, then you really mostly shouldn't care. This product is for you if you're on a platform that's limiting your growth, and if your stomach is turning into knots about the cost and the time to rebuild your entire e-commerce infrastructure. Remember, Optimizer replaces just your content, category, and product pages. Really everything that matters for SEO. Your current e-commerce platform serves everything else, and your admin panel also remains the same. But of course, if your e-commerce platform is a dinosaur and it really doesn't have an API or a mechanism to programmatically interact, then Commerce Optimizer is not going to be a fit either. At that point, I'd recommend a full evaluation of all e-commerce platform players, not just Adobe. And we here at SwiftOtter know quite a few in great detail, We are your perfect partner to help you make a super long-lasting decision. So if you made it this far and you're curious about what it takes to implement Adobe Commerce Optimizer on your website, let me give you a really fast overview of how we walk you through this migration process. The first step is to ensure that there is actually a connector from your e-commerce platform to Optimizer. While custom ones can be built to pull data from literally any source, using pre-built connectors is going to dramatically reduce your migration costs, and that's what we're all after, right? We then review your current website's content, category, and product pages to compare them with the new front-end experience. You can keep the look and feel as is, or you can take this as an opportunity to incrementally adjust your website's design. Remember, leveraging Commerce Optimizer means you get to keep your existing platform, whether that's Salesforce Commerce Cloud, Shopify, BigCommerce, Magento 2, whatever it is. Optimizer then is a new experience for your highest impact pages, your homepage, content pages, category pages, and even product pages. The cost then becomes far less than a complete replatform, which means the timeline is shorter, which means you will see ROI faster, and we'd love to build such an optimized website for you. If you're interested in learning more about if and how Optimizer can benefit your e-commerce experience, let's chat. We're highly experienced in building headless websites and would love to explore if this is the right fit indeed for you. Email me, joseph@swiftotter.com, and I would love to introduce you to the really talented members of our team.